She just wants to be beautiful. She goes unnoticed. She knows no limits. She craves attention. She praises an image. She prays to be sculpted by the sculptor. Oh, she don't see the light that's shining deeper than the eyes can find it. Maybe we are made of blind souls. She tries to cover up her pain and cut her woes away. 'Cause cover girls don't cry after the face is made. But there's a hope that's waiting for you in the dark. You should know you're beautiful just the way you are. And you don't have to change a thing. The world could change its heart. No scars, see, you're beautiful. We're stars and we're beautiful.
When do you leave for Arizona, Kate?
July 7th, I think.
Oh my god, that is so early though.
I still can't believe you're going.
I'm really excited.
Oh my god, and a full ride too. That's awesome.
Throwing a party today.
Are your parents coming on?
Yes. It's gonna be so lit. Please come.
It was a normal day at Notre Dame. Classes were in session, and I was hanging out with my friends and my sister. It was the last month of school before we all went off to college. These were the last moments we would have together. Maddie let everyone know that she was holding a party at her house that afternoon. And since all my friends were going, I thought it might be a good idea to tag along.
Hey, promise you won't drive.
No, yeah, I'll be fine. It's okay. Don't worry
Jesse,
about it.
Jesse, look at me.
I'll be fine. Really?
Serious. You promise me you won't drive.
Okay. Okay. I promise.
I gotta go.
Okay.
Over here.
Over here.
When I come back, you know what it look like. Everything lit, all the girls in free. Anybody inside, sipping on a good time. You ain't got a risk, they can get it on me. When they wanna go, they know all my money sure. I don't ever get it one way, yeah. Spend it, then I get it same day, but hey.
From nothing to something. Hey, I don't trust nobody, grip the trigger. Nobody call up the gang and they come and get gang. Cry me a river, give you a tissue. It's bad and bullshit. Bad cooking up with a Uzi. My niggas are savage, ruthless. We got 30s and 100 rounds too. My is bad and bullshit. Bad cooking up with a Uzi. My niggas are savage, ruthless. We got 30s and 100 rounds too.
All set.
Woo, 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 woo. Records on records, got backers on backers. I'm riding around in a coupe.
Cool.
I take your right from you.
You,
I'm a dog. Roof. Beat her walls loose.
Hey.
Hop in the frog. Woo.
Scream.
I tell that bitch to come for me.
Come for me.
I swear these n****s is under me.
Hey.
The hate and the devil keep jumping me.
Jumping me.
Back rows on me, keep me company.
I can drive you home. It's fine. Oh, it's okay. It's my last drink, and then I'll be fine. I will. Are you sure? Yeah. You know me. I'm always fine.
Hey, Matt.
I'm always fine.
Oh, fine.
Remember? Never loved us. I'm on my worst.
get it f***ed up. Motherfuckers never loved us. Man, motherfuckers never loved us. Worst behavior. Never loved us. Never loved us. Worst behavior.
T-U-P-I-D. When we go to the club, we don't need ID. Everywhere we go, it's a party, y'all. We gon' get it cracking like the Mardi Gras. Get stupid, get stupid, get stupid, get stupid. Go stupid, go stupid, go stupid.
911, what's the location of your emergency?
We need help. We need
Hello?
Help.
Hello?
I need help right now.
Okay, where are you?
We're in the back of Notre Dame High School by the back gate. There's so much blood, like you need help.
Okay,
right
okay,
now.
Hold on. Calm down. What's going on?
We need help. There's a car crash and I don't know. You have to come right now.
Jessica, you have the right to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be used against you in the court of law. You have the right to the presence of an attorney before and during any questioning. If you cannot afford an attorney, one will be appointed for you free of charge before any questioning. Do you understand?
Yes. I'm worried about a pneumothorax on the right. Do you have breath sounds on the right? No breath sounds. Okay, let's prepare to needle decompress, please. Decompress the chest. Okay, I heard a rush of air. Let's go ahead and secure that. All right, we're taking a look here, guys. It looks like we have a belly full of blood. I'm worried about internal injuries.
Thank you. Jack's Bistro.
Katie was in an accident and she is gone.
What?
What? She was in an accident coming back from a party. And.
What are you talking about?
Yes.
What do you mean she's gone? She's gone where?
She's passed away. She's.
I'm Sergeant Peter Lottie, Press Information Officer, the City of Belmont and the Belmont Police Department. Today I have a prepared statement for you regarding an injury collision that occurred earlier in the day, and I will not be fielding any questions at this time. Upon arrival, two female passengers were pronounced dead on scene, while another was transported to Stanford Hospital. Unfortunately, that juvenile female also succumbed to her injuries and was pronounced deceased by hospital staff. Five other juvenile passengers suffered minor injuries and are expected to survive at this time.
All of her life, she's been a hardworking, dedicated, honest, rule-following kind of kid. I know that you have to pass judgment on this and come to some kind of decision in terms of how she will be impacted. And I'd just like to say that the kind of pain that she has now is a pain that she will have to live with for the rest of her life. No matter what happens today, she is going to be punished for the rest of her life. And I hope that the court would take that into consideration as you look at the judgment today. I guess the question I would ask to you is, what would you do as a parent? Would you want to punish that child, or would you want to take that child in your arms and tell them how you felt about them and tell them that you would be there to support them no matter what happened?
You ask me, what would I do if I were a parent? Mr. Flores, my role today is not to act as a parent. My role today is to act as a judge. Ms. Flores, you are lucky to have the parents that you have that came here and vouched for you after the way that you have abused their trust. You knew the dangers of drinking and driving, and you decided to do it anyway. For what? For what? For this? Is it worth it? Your conduct was the ultimate selfishness. Because you chose to drink and drive, because you chose not to allow a sober person to drive, because you chose not to call a parent. Had you been caught driving under the influence and nobody was hurt, that would be a mistake. But what you have done is committed a horrific crime. And your father is right, you will be paying for this for the rest of your life without any doubt. Because you are an adult, you will be going to state prison. And you will be spending the next 8 years of your life in the California Department of Corrections. Please take her out of this courtroom and into custody. Court is adjourned.
Brittany told me not to go to the party. She told me not to drink. She even told me not to drive, but I didn't listen. I remember seeing my sister's eyes as I drove into the car she was in. I tried to stop, but it was just too late. I killed my sister and my friends, and I can't do anything to change what happened. My name is Jessica Flores. I was convicted of vehicular manslaughter, and I've been sentenced to 8 years in prison. But the biggest sentence is the choice I now have to live with the rest of my life. Katie, Tamara, Brittany, I'm sorry. I'm so, so sorry.